The SUMIF function adds up numbers that meet a criteria and returns the total. The condition may be tested on the same range or a different one. Let's see some examples. This formula adds up all the values of cells equal to 3 in A1 to F1. The range is the first argument, and the criteria is the second argument. Only cells from the range in the first argument that meet the criteria are included in the sum. 3 plus 3 is 6. The values in these cells are excluded from the sum because they are not 3. Notice that the criteria is inside quotation marks and begins with a comparison operator. This is how it is normally written. This example shows both possible exceptions to the criteria syntax. The equal to comparison operator is assumed if no comparison operator is included, and the quotation marks can be excluded for numbers. This formula adds the positive values in A3 to F3. 100 plus 50 plus 73 is 223. The values in these cells are excluded from the sum because they are not greater than 0. This formula adds the values not equal to H4 in A4 to F4. 200 plus negative 30 is the same as 200 minus 30, which is 170. The values in these cells are excluded because they are not equal to H4. H4 contains 100, and so do these cells. The SUMIF function ignores blanks and text in the range being summed, just as the sum function does. Criteria can include references in this way. The comparison operator should be enclosed in quotation marks, but the reference should not. In all the examples we have seen so far, there have been two arguments, with the criteria being assessed against the range in the first argument, and values summed from that same range. When a third argument is included, the criteria is assessed against the range in the first argument, and the values are summed from the range in the third argument. This formula adds the values in A7 to F7, which correspond to the include entries in A6 to F6. These cells meet the criteria, so the values in these corresponding cells are summed. 100 plus 400 plus 500 is 1000. The normal way to use SUMIF with three arguments is as we have done here, with the first and third arguments as ranges of the same size and shape. In fact, only the size and shape of the range in the first argument matters. The values are summed from a range which starts from the most upper left cell in the third argument and corresponds in size and shape to the range in the first argument. This is the range in the first argument. And these are the cells that meet the not equal to no criteria. So the values in these cells are added. 10 plus 10 plus 10 is 30. We can change the size and shape of the third argument, and provided cell A13 remains as the upper left cell, the formula will be evaluated the same way. You can always check the help article in your instance of Excel. My channel includes a function overview video that provides practical information on finding and using functions generally, as well as videos introducing other commonly used functions. The ExcelFinancialModeling.com website has more free resources. All the links are in the description. Thanks for watching.